Hello viewer, welcome to my YouTube channel Nigeria Politics. We focus on political matters happening in and around agriculture in Nigeria. For first time viewers, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel by clicking the red button below. Also, hit on the bell button so you will always get notifications when a news story drops. Here's today's headline. Ihedioha has not started governing Imo State. Rochas Okorocha. The story begins. The former governor of Imo State, Rochas Okorocha, has said that his successor, Emeka Ihedioha, is yet to start governing the state since taking power. Below is a statement signed by Okorocha's spokesperson, Onwuemeodo. It is important to state and indeed inform the general public that the new governor of Imo State, Chief Emeka Ihedioha, has not begun to govern the state as his chief executive, looking at his activities and utterances so far, but embarking on oversight functions as if he is still at the National Assembly, where he was uninterruptedly for 12 years. He has also been busy setting up a series of committees with at least 3 committees a day and has never done any serious thing or taken any serious step or said any serious thing to show that he has actually taken the seat as the governor of the state. And he also seems not to have cared about asking questions. In the course of doing oversight function, even as governor, he will go to one bad dredging site, which he won't mention where it is. He will send out the photograph just to blackmail his predecessor, or he will send out the photograph of one bad toilet he got from somewhere and said it was in a government house. So petty and unserious all these days. The former governor left more than 1,000 verifiable projects behind for him. He has never cared to visit any of the projects to show that he has come to work and that he means well. If he could be showing the world one bad toilet we knew they got for Owerri office of the PDP when landmark projects are located at various parts of the state waiting for him to come and see them and know what to do with them, then he hasn't come for service. The International Cargo Airport is ready and was commissioned by the Vice President Prof. Let him visit the place and tell the world what he has seen, and then open it for operation so that the purpose for building such a landmark project can be achieved. The ultra-modern prison headquarters and the magnificent police headquarters also built by his predecessor and commissioned by the Vice President needs his action. He should ask the police to move to such befitting edifice and the prison people too. The management of the Skyrun company his predecessor had also brought would like him to come and see what God has used Owerri to do for Imo people. The 6 new universities, 4 polytechnics, 3 colleges of education, the 27 general hospitals, the ultra-modern market built by the former governor, including the Malaysia market at Obobo, are all waiting for him to come and see them and know the level which as a culture are taking the states to in terms of development and their work will enable him to know what to do. Showing the world one bad dredging site also caused by the PDP people when they held sway on one bad toilet at the expense of the more than 1,000 projects his person left behind does not show good spirit. He does not need to embark on new projects. He should rather maintain or strengthen the ones on ground where the need arises. The other day, he was showing a bad classroom block at the Holy Ghost College Owerri, and he failed or refused to tell his audience that the college is owned by the Catholic Diocese of Owerri. But he could not also show Government College Owerri, or Emmanuel College, or Akwakuma Girls College, or Ikenogu Girls College, or Government Technical College, which Owerri Okorocha had been branded to the admission of all and sundry. This is not how to be a governor. He should not be trying hard to run down the man who handed over to him a brand new state. The truth is that what the APC-led government of Rochas Okorocha achieved in 8 years, the PDP government, even for 50 years, cannot achieve 1/10 of such laudable achievements, especially when it takes financial discipline or prudence and vision to do so. Governor Ihedioha should wake up from his dead slumber and show the people of Imo State that he is their governor and that he has come to build and not to destroy or find fault where none exists. Please leave a comment below. Thank you.